How's it going, everyone? This is 17 Master here with you, and welcome officially to Season 2 of the Sacred Stones Iron Man Randomizer. But before we begin, I do owe all of you a quick rundown of our unit so far. First, we have Franz as a level 14 fighter, looking pretty good with that strength and speed. Defense leaves a bit to be desired. HP is low for a fighter, but what can you do? It's a randomizer. He's been kind of hard carrying so far, so he definitely has first dibs on a hero crest if I get one. Actually, I think I already have one. I don't remember. I'll check in a minute. Anyways, next we have Vanessa, who rolled Wyvern Rider. Her strength is a bit lacking, but everything else is looking really good about her, so I'm going to keep using her. I have faith. I have faith that that strength will turn around. Mamie rolled Monk. And I mean, she still targets res. She still has 1-2 range, so there's certainly a niche for her. And she does have the support with Calm going, so I mean, that's always something I can fall back on. Gillian rolled Archer with his high strength, and he's able to just kind of smack enemies really hard once, and that's good enough. He'll probably fall off soon, but until then, I'm gonna make use of him. Now we have Calm, who rolled Shaman. Has a bit of a better stat spread than Amy, mainly because of the speed. And if I'm lucky, if I can find another Dark Tome without having to buy it from the Preparations Armory, that would be great. Here's Seth. Seth is Seth. There's really nothing I can say about Seth that hasn't already been said since 2004, so I'm not going to bother trying. Joshua stayed a Myrmidon. Actually, Joshua rolled female Myrmidon. Slight correction. And doing pretty well so far. Here's Mulder. Probably gonna fall off soon, but I mean, I can still make good use of that magic for a bit longer, I think. Unfortunately, Natasha rolled a really bad strength and skill, so I don't think... I really can't get anything out of that. Same with Arthur, and it's even worse for him because he rolled Recruit. Garcia's? Maybe I could have done something with this, but I don't know. I just wasn't feeling it. Rip Ross. And the star of our show this time is Ephraim. As a Myrmidon, his stats are actually pretty similar to Joshua's. Which is a good thing because Joshua's stats are really good. And I can definitely put this to work. Once again, forward roll cleric. Having a healer is having a healer. Enough said there. And I'll probably start using Kyle over Gilliam just because he has a bit more speed so he can double the slow enemies like the soldiers. And the armor knights, so that'll probably come in handy. We'll see. And there we are. So before we begin, I am gonna do one more pass around and just make sure that everybody is good on equipment. Everyone has stuff I can use. If I need to go to the shop, I will. Actually, aside. Do I have a guiding ring? I guess I can go get a steel bows for Gilliam. Actually, I'll probably just keep using Gilliam because his strength is so much higher than Kyle's. We have 10 here and what, like 12? It's not that much higher. Maybe I do use Kyle. Yeah, I think it's a Kyle play, actually. What's his con? 7 versus... Okay, he even has more con. Yeah, so it's a Kyle angle. And I can't buy Dark Tones yet, right? Nah. Because you're not expected to be able to until... At least until you get Ewan. If not Null. But anyways, let's get a move on. We've deliberated long enough. And I will get my battle preparations on the way, and I will catch up with y'all in just a moment. Okay, let's do this thing. Tana has also rolled archer. I have so many archers this seed. But that's our fourth archer now. Gilliam, Kyle, Natasha, yep. Anyways, let's get a move on. Okay, off to a strong start here with this critical. And what do you got for us, Naimi? I would have liked more. Let's see, you don't reach, right? Okay, so these two don't reach. Steel bow, so 16 might. So you do 2 damage. Get weighed down by 2, so you're at 7 speed to hurt. Okay, so she doesn't double, which, bit of a bummer. I can put Slide Vanessa in here. France can come here, equip the hatchet, and everybody else just rolls down. Oh, this is a fairly straightforward chapter. Oh, but I do need to do my Tana review. Wait, she kept her iron bow. She's not supposed to have that. Holy shit! Welcome to the team, Princess Tana. Can you just kill this guy? Not quite. Holy shit! That is so good! Okay, yeah, I'll wait. I'll let him attack into her first. Just in case that crit chance decides to mess with me. Okay, we found our archer. Holy jeez, and Tana has really good growths too, so that's gonna be fun. Okay, no one else wants to move, that's fine. You have 20 attack, so that's 21 and 20. So Vanessa could take you both on, actually. Or wait, well, hold on. Okay, that guy doesn't come close to reaching. So we take out this guy. Do a little heal. I need to turn off Forge animations. Just a second. Set that there. Cool. Okay. I'll put France here to deal with the archer. Ephraim can come here, and if they want to take him on, then they can choose that fate. Okay. Oh, whoops. It would have been really tragic if He got the crit because I forgot to attack with Tana. I forgot just that quickly that she had a weapon, because she normally doesn't. Good dodge. Okay, the cavalry is moving. Shouldn't be a problem. I will need to check the weapon just to verify who has swords and who has lances, but this should not be an issue. That could be an issue. Good dodge, okay. Okay, before I forget. Okay, she can slowly take this guy out. And you don't reach. Cool. Kyle, you can come here. Actually, where's that from? Okay, so you just wrecked this guy. Nice. Vanessa's about to level up, so she can set up. She doesn't hurt this guy. Bummer. That sets up the kill for Vanessa, but who else could I give it to? Let me just thinking this over. Gilliam kills. I guess the question becomes, do I want to try to use Colm and Naimi long term? Because if I get Colm to Summoner, then that becomes a super good resource for an Ironman run. Which is what I think I want to do. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. Because Summoner's Phantoms will be absurdly useful. Then we can just chip down this cavalier. Come on, Vanessa. You know what? She got strength, I'll take it. That is all right. Water doesn't reach. Now I'm trying to think. If I had. Well, if Naimi gets more magic, then with Slayer, she could be useful for the late game. Possibly. I think that's worth considering. Okay, lots of cavaliers, but we have a choke point. So I'm not too worried. Wait, is that Amelia? That is Amelia. Ooh. Well, she is another staff user. But goodness. I don't even think, even I can't even defend that. Well, she'll be safe at least. Good crit, good crit. Yeah, she'll sit safely on the bench, where she won't die this time. Okay, what are we looking at? Iron sword, heavy spear, iron lance, sword javelin. So they've got a mix of weapons, okay. Yeah, this is the Vanessa tanks everything, and we just beat them up from the behind the choke point. It's not the most exciting strategy, but it's safe and it's basically guaranteed to work. Okay, good magic. Keep these two next to each other so they can get that A rank. And I think in a few turns, reinforcements appear from these stairs. So what I'm going to do is position some of these guys for an ambush and some of them to deal with the cavaliers. I was about to say she can't even one round the soldiers, but she can do that. Okay, at least it's the last of the sleep staff uses. And they all miss, so that's wonderful. Haha. Ooh, not that. It's a fortress that no one can reach. Okay, Calm can yoink this one. I probably should have Vanessa attack that one first to soften him up to save my a flux use, but it is what it is. I could just, I don't even have to choke point this, I could just run him over. What am I doing? Yeah, let's just run him over. That is so much overkill. Okay, Vanessa. You're making your point. We'll drop the slim lock. I do need that key. And you have steel. There's the longbow. And unfortunately, once again, I don't have a thief, so getting that red gem is out of the question. Which is a little saddening, but is what it is. And this is a bit risky. If Naimi misses, then Gillian might die. Actually, that's not true. If Naimi misses, I just use Saf. What am I saying? And she has 100 hit. I wasn't paying attention to the numbers. Okay, she has gotten magic both levels. I would like that she got more than just the magic, but she did get magic both times. Tana kills that. Wait, hold on. 12 crit. That's a little scary. Get Joshua some action. He hasn't seen anything yet. Okay. So far, so good. Okay, so she can hurt some of the knights, but barely. And I need to watch out for the longbows. Like, even with her defense, those things are gonna hurt if she gets hit by them. I think 7 plus 15 is 22. So that's only 5 damage. Still better to not get hit if I can avoid it, since she cannot retaliate. Meanwhile, Franz can deal with this. Granted, he's still really good, despite that level up. But unfortunate. Joshua can deal with that. Meanwhile, everyone else should be moving in. All right, Tana, what have you got for us? Okay. That is a very good first impression. I think I can't open up that door though, because that invites the mercenary. Well, he won't be in range, but... Or will... I'll double check. Actually, no, I can't remember. Okay, we're not opening the door. Or we're not breaking open the wall. Was that triggered by opening the door? Is that what it was? It makes sense. Okay. Good dodge. It wouldn't have been too big of a deal if that hit, but having it miss is, of course, better. Okay, the shaman. I thought there gonna be more shamans. That's why I parked Joshua there. Can Kyle clean this up? Yes. We do this. And in between, what is your 12 speed, 17 attack, so you do 9 damage? Yep. But in no world do you double, okay. So France is fine there, but I would like to get Ephraim in the action. So we'll position him here. Hold on. Whoops. What if I... And then I think Ephraim can clean this up. Right? Yeah, that's what I want to see. And we can just kind of make our way up. And Tana's gonna chill here. I could have swapped off the... Holy shit, Vanessa. No! I should have checked their weapons. And that was a very lucky dodge, but I should have checked that. Okay, did they all? Okay, so for each of these, one of them is gonna have a javelin. And we don't have vulnerary, so we need to move Tana up here. Okay. Amelia is the cleric. Actually, what I could do. Let me just see something. Never mind. That's not a play. That is not at all a play. That's fine. Because the sooner we clear these guys out quickly, and then we don't have to worry about... Then we only have to worry about the Cavaliers. Let's see, we can recruit Amelia. Mortar can... I guess I just use Vanessa here. No need to overthink it. And you guys start moving in. Ford pretty tanky. 17, so you take 6 damage if you get hit. That's fine. Okay. Yeah, these archers gotta go first, because they're just being really annoying. Then if I use Calm can probably, yeah, Calm can take this guy out. What's your void? 12 to his 105 hits, so that's for 93. I'll have to get Naimi a bit closer to keep the affinity bonus, but that's fine. Take the chip XP. Now Calm can take out this guy cleanly. Now there's still another archer, so I can't move Vanessa in just yet. At least not on this side. But I can move her over here. I should have checked for a horse layer before I, in my inventory before I started this chapter. Smack this guy from over the wall. Please hit. Nice. And I think Mortar can finish him off. What do you have? 6 res. 13 attack. But you have 7 speed. It's both 7 speed, so never mind. The Sunblade again? Okay. Move everyone in. And I'm fine with Mortar moving up here. Whoever that Cavalier decides to attack, I'm okay with it. Because it just means that he's moving into my range. Good dodge. And we get the double. Sweet. That gets rid of that guy. And now I can deal with these Cavaliers. Alright. So far, so good. I'll give this one to Joshua as he catches up. Calm can. Yeah, we'll start with Vanessa. Just lay on the chip, and we'll figure it out who's gonna get it. Mortar can take out this guy, that's fine. Okay. Let's see, if France deals with this one, then Ephraim can hit the next one. Yeah, that just seems like an easy. Yeah, let's just do that. Don't need to think about it too much. It's unfortunate because France isn't getting much experience from these guys anymore. They're level 9 to his level 15, so. I should probably be focusing on letting my single digit level units get these kills. At least the one that I'm trying to use. Let's see who's. On strength. Okay. It is now technically possible for Gilliam to land double attacks. So yeah, I'm just gonna just do this. I'm not gonna bother. There's more enemies I can take out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you have a killing guy. So if I'm in the off chance that I'm wrong and this guy starts moving, that's really bad news. Like, I'm pretty sure he doesn't move until someone's actually in his attacking range, but I also don't have to risk it. Like, I don't really gain much by taking that chance, so I'm not going to. And she had one more move. I guess I'll just bait this guy out with Naimi. And actually, don't you have a sleep staff? You do, okay. There's no way I get hit by a I get crit by a 15 and 2. Right? There's no way. Next chapter, I'll have to remember to get hand axes because that hatch is about to break. Or actually, wait, I think I have a second one. I'll have to double check. I might have another one in my armory or my supply. Okay, we're good. Gosh. The amount of rage I would have felt if she actually got crit there. Just take you out. So. God, our strength is so low. It's getting better, but still, it's. Actually, what's my key situation? I don't have my chest keys. Oh wait, no, I used them in I have the one that Tana has. That's right, I used them in chapter 8. I think this one is the one that's normally the ocean seal. Seth can go break Tana out and then kind of just body block for her while she deals with the Myrmidon and the fighter here. And everyone else is just gonna rush to the throne room. Vanessa, you can hold those guys off. I need to get rid of you. So what if I trade over the longbow? Move Joshua. I need to be careful because these guys move immediately. And I sent Vanessa out of the way, so I can't rely, so she can't help. But if I were to do this. Ah! Yep. Okay. All right. This is fine. Actually, I kind of need to keep Millie down here, I think. Because we're about to need her help. What are your weapons? Iron Lance, Steel Lance, Javelin. Go ahead and finish off this guy before he gets healed. So you have 13 speed. Yep. And 18 damage. So even for crit, he only does 9. And Seth weighs down enough with the Iron Blade to not double, I'm pretty sure. That may have been a bad idea. Yeah, that was a bad idea. That was a really bad idea. And they have 13 defense, but they double. If I do this, then that limits who all can actually hit him. Okay. Yeah, mistakes were made, but this is salvageable. That's fine. Okay, so the Iron Lance guy went in first, so. Which means now the Steel Lance user doesn't have room. Good dodge. What is that, 4 criticals from Vanessa this chapter? Okay, thank goodness. Lots of cavaliers. But you know what? This is... I don't know if it's fine. Saying this is fine might be an overstatement. Okay, France wakes up next turn. I think this could all go south pretty quickly. If I'm either not careful or if RNG works against me. So for now, I'm not going to use the Sunblade, otherwise Ephraim will run through the Cavaliers too well. He can end up getting himself killed. Let's see, if I move Joshua here, I put him in a spot where he can get hit twice. I don't know if I want to do that. I guess I could just leave these two here and let them frontline the Cavaliers. And just keep them topped off. We'll just stay here. Okay, no more Cavaliers. Thank goodness. Okay. So we do this. I'm just falling short on kill power too often. That's unfortunate. I should have double checked. This is a bad idea. Like even in best case scenario, that's not the play. Just every which way, I lack kill power. Okay, Colm, show me something good. Go there. The problem is if I move Ephraim down, then he's just going to get hit by everyone. Although, if I do... So, knight, so he has 20 attack, 16 attack, and 16 attack to his 7 defense. No, I don't think I can do that. Even if I heal, I think that's a bad idea. Okay. I would like to be a little more reckless, but I don't think the math works in my favor. And I don't want a game over here. Nice. Okay, let's just end turn. I suppose one of them would have attacked Gilliam because they can't counter. Well, keeping that in... Actually, no, never mind. That guy just does too much damage. It's not worth the risk. Yeah, because then if that guy had hit... Yeah, it'd just be a scary situation that I don't need to put myself in. So never mind. Okay, let's start carving a path once and for all. Two, three, four, five. That would have been a nice time to crit. So good. Actually, we might not be fine. Oh, that's a thunder. Wait. Don't miss. Okay, thank goodness. Okay, not bad. Not even close. No! Oh. Oh, that was so clutch. Oh man. That's... Oh gosh. I would have been very sad. I would have been so sad. But you know what? We're okay. She's alive and that's all that matters. Okay, one more push and we'll be done with this chapter. So I might take the time to, well, depends on if she can damage him, but having Tana just kind of smack Gheb for the easy XP sounds like a good idea. Sounds appealing. Wait, why can't anyone pick her up? Strange. Okay. Me too, Naomi. Me too. Alright. Those two got their A rings, so that's a lot of bonus avoid and accuracy. And critical evasion, so they'll be... It's all in all pretty good. I feel like Dark is actually a better affinity than I used to give it credit for. Okay. Appreciate your assistance, Gilliam. Now it is time for an archer with a speed stat to take over. Franz, yeah, Franz smacks this guy, and then Joshua can deal with the mercenary. I really hope that the chapter 10 shop has dark tomes. I don't think it does. But if it does, then I'm saved. Otherwise, then I'm just gonna have to go a little bit without using calm. And the last of this action, I think, can go to Tana. Where is she? Way back here. Just to help her start getting caught up in level. Actually, who does Tana support from this team? Does she support Vanessa? Hang on, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Unfortunately, Tana does not support Vanessa. So that idea is off the table. She does support Irene, though. Alright, but now all we have left is Gheb. Now, Gheb has tremendous attack. But, as is a recurring joke that has been known since I started playing Fire Emblem, he lacks 1 to 2 range, or any kind of 2 range, which kind of makes him fodder for any ranged units that can hit him, that can damage him. And we have just enough attack with the iron bow to do so. And yeah, I'm gonna do it. I'm not gonna put the whole thing in, but I am gonna take this chance to just give Tana the free experience until either these bows break or until she's caught up to the others. Let me get Ephraim up here and ready. Actually, hold on. What's your Ephraim is Dark Affinity. And Tana is, they're both Dark Affinity. It doesn't give me attack or defense, but it would be full everything else. So they're both just getting crit, accuracy, critical avoid, and avoid off each other. I think I like that idea. Let's do it. Wait. Oh, the throne. I forgot about the throne. The throne gives plus 3. Can't you hurt him with the steel bow? Barely. Perfect. Yeah, this might take a while. Which is why I'm gonna skip ahead. I'll keep the level ups in. I'll try to, but yeah, this is gonna take a minute. So I'll see you when we're making some headway. Okay, we're getting strength and everything else. That's actually gonna help. And that bit of skill will also get us over the 50% mark, so we can set out our RNG should lean a little bit more in our favor because of how 2 RN works. Okay, so unfortunately our steel bow is broken and we don't have enough attack to damage him with the iron bow yet. So unless I have a... Nope, that's the same might as an iron bow. So we're kind of stuck. But I mean... Those are incredible stats. Like, no matter how you slice it. I could do Namie next. I don't know if I... We can get her to level 10. I think that's fine. I'm not gonna go too crazy because I kind of want to be done with this. And actually, now that I'm looking at it, this is a little bit spooky. Well, actually, no, I got the Axe Reaver from that Armor Knight. Who has it? So I could just use Vanessa with the Axe Reaver. That's probably my play. Actually, yeah, I've got it. I know what to do. So you two move over here. And who else has... Anyone else have the con to... Just friends? Okay, that's gonna make this a little rougher than I would like. But what I'm thinking... is that if Vanessa attacks... Jeez, that does a little damage. He's so tanky. He's so tanky. Ugh. That hit. Oh my gosh. But basically, I can kind of loop like this. Since he starts wooding the iron axe, I want to keep him on that. One, because it's much less dangerous than the killer axe. And two, if I can beat him before he switches, he'll drop the killer axe. If he switches to the killer axe, then he'll drop the iron axe, which is, of course, much less valuable. So yeah, I'm gonna do like some rescue dropping shenanigans to try to wear him down without letting him switch weapons. Come on, Joshua. And meanwhile, Naomi can get her poke in. And yeah, this will be the strat. And we'll just slowly wear him down like this. Or quickly if Joshua decides to get a critical. Ask and you shall receive. One more critical. So close. One more turn should one more turn should do it. Alley-oop. Okay, we are out of here. excuse me, sorry. That took longer than I would have anticipated, but hey, we're done. Everybody's alive. We successfully got Amelia, and I wrapped up chapter 9. All right, thank you all for watching. Thanks for keeping up with the series, even as we start a new season. Hope you enjoyed it as much as the first. And I hope to catch you all next time when we take on Chapter 10, Turning Traitor. Bye!